Hi, if you are wondering what is the best autofocus mode to get sharp photo, we need to first look at the different focus mode on your camera and when to use them. Most cameras have three different modes. Those three are single focus mode, continuous mode, and manual focus. Today with the mirrorless system, we also have face and eye focus system mode. Okay, let's go through each one of them so that you know when and how to use it. What is single focus mode and when to use it? Single focus is suitable to use when your subject is stationary and not moving. It is suitable for landscape, product photos, generally anything that is not moving. Let me show you how it works. Okay, first, most cameras are already set by default on single autofocus mode. But if not, to change it on Nikon, you can press the button on the side and use your back dial to change it to single. For some other cameras, you can select it on your menu. Single focus means once you select the subject you want to focus on and half press the shutter, the focus will lock, and as long as your finger holds down the shutter button halfway, the focus will not change anymore until you take the photo or release the shutter button and refocus. If you are going to focus and recompose, for example, your subject is far away from your autofocus box, normally I will focus my subject with nearest focus point and lock the focus by keeping the button halfway pressed, or sometimes I will use the autofocus back button at the back of my camera, then I will recompose and press the shutter button fully to take the shot I wanted. With this technique, the focus will remain on my subject even when it is not in the autofocus point anymore. Limited focus coverage is typical with most DSLR body because the autofocus box is only at the center, maybe around 80 to 90% of the viewfinder. One thing to keep in mind, if your camera is moving towards or away from the subject, or your subject move while you lock your focus, your subject will not be in focus anymore. That is because the focus distance changed due to movement while your focus was locked. When recomposing in a single autofocus mode, be careful not to change the distance to your subject as you are recomposing. Oh yeah, before we proceed to get sharp focus, I highly recommend using small or single point area autofocus if the subject is static. You can use the joystick on your camera to pinpoint exactly where to focus. This is because when using autofocus mode area, sometimes it will focus not exactly what you want. Okay, moving on to the next autofocus mode, continuous focus. To switch continuous autofocus mode for Nikon camera, you can press the autofocus button and use back dial to change it, similar to single autofocus. Okay, now, where do you use continuous mode? And what does it mean? Continuous mode is once you half press the shutter and don't let it go, it will continue to focus where you pinpoint the focus point. It will keep track the subject you select to focus on. This mode is great for tracking a continuous moving subject, unlike single autofocus mode where it's good for static subject. Normally, I will use continuous mode to shoot action or sports or anything that I need to track a subject that is moving. Okay, while single and continuous autofocus mode is amazing, then when we should use manual focus mode? Manual focus mode is a great option to use when autofocus does not work well due to not much contrast in the scene. For example, when I'm using a macro lens to focus on the details such as white cream, the autofocus will keep hunting. To get sharp image, I will override the autofocus by turning the manual focus ring. Bear in mind, not all lens allow you to turn or override the autofocus. Some lens will need you to disengage the autofocus drive before you can manually focus. Another scene where you should use manual focus is when making time lapse, because we do not want the focus to shift and will create inconsistent focus footage. Lastly, with latest technology, most mirrorless camera comes with face and eye autofocus. To activate this, you must switch to full autofocus mode area. But again, the same thing applies to this mode where you have single autofocus mode and continuous autofocus mode. This come handy when you want to take a portrait shot and have no time to adjust or move your focusing point. Okay, I hope you understand about autofocus mode. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Thank you for watching.